Wake up. Oh. You died of malnourishment. And guess what? Now you have to go do it all again. I guess you turned autosave off. That was a great idea. So the nice part about Ohio is that December doesn't mean anything and winter's a joke, because we have winter in all other seasons, any time of the year. So I took advantage of it being in the high 50s, low 60s. It was looking really good. I had a small window to get this job done, a job that I'd never done before, but I'd watched enough videos that I felt confident that what's the worst that could happen? I blew up the motor, the car barely runs now as it is, so what's the point of struggling with this one? Worst case scenario, we have to get a new motor. So, after watching a couple videos, valve covers seem like a pretty easy job, so... And for those of you that didn't watch the other parts, we're going in there for a timing chain. And the water pump leaks, so might as well two birds, one stone while you're in here. All in all, anybody that's done work on these Ecotecs knows that the air cleaner covers everything up, and the wiring harness is in the way. But it's so fragile that you don't want to just yank it out of the way, and then... I'm not even sure if I have electrical issues at this point. Never quarter. Make sure you find a good sturdy part to pry on, and double check that all the bolts are out. I think I had one that was still... Nope, that gasket's just old. This engine's never been opened up, so these gaskets held up really well for factory. I think if I was going to do this again, I would definitely pull the wiring harness back a lot farther than I did. Also, that little engine mount on the side, it looks like you can snake it around, just take it off. It's two bolts, it takes no time. They're not open or anything, so you don't have to worry about oil or coolant or anything, so just take them off. And don't do what I did. This washer container can be taken off with the air cleaner on. There's plenty of room. But I ended up dropping washer fluid down in the motor, so we were doing an oil change anyway. Oh my god. Would you believe this? Look at why I'm in here. This sprocket on both sides and the chain are off by an entire tooth. An entire tooth. How did we jump timing? Now when I got down in here, nothing was lined up. I have no idea how this car still ran. With ignoring that, I knew that I had no chance of, or I had a slight chance of getting to top dead center. And then I had a different type of struggle where I had a lot more work and a lot less time than I thought to do all of this work. So I put the camera down and crunch time started. I got everything but the water pump and the thermostat housing off on day one. Day two was freezing, but all I got done was getting the thermostat housing off and open and then getting the water pump removed. Day three, I thought I could do it. All I had to do was put everything back together. And what did I do? I made it all the way through. Even got the car started. Everything was great. I had done everything correctly. But in my haste, I snapped off two bolts in the back of the thermostat housing, which, as anybody knows, is on the back of the engine. And somehow I got rewarded by being able to take these bolts out with nothing more than a screw extractor. Luckily, I was able to go to an auto parts store and get the proper bolts. Luckily, these ones won't be snapped off because I won't. It's 89 inch pounds for all these bolts. All because I had a small leak because I was too lazy to replace that gasket. Then we put in some fresh oil. And we went out for a little rip. I can't tell you how much I miss this car. My only problem was, he ran like crap. So then I figured, well, if he runs like crap, something's gotta be wrong. So let's dive back in and pull them all apart. Just to find out that my timing was completely wrong. Something had happened. I don't know. So, I guess we'll just start all over again. The only problem was, there was weather coming. Now, the forecast said it was supposed to be nice all day and then rain at 5. Well, the countdown started. Thank you. was done. I had felt so defeated. I was ready to give up on all of it. I was ready to sell the car. I was ready to move. I was broken. But after stripping out of soaking wet clothes, taking a hot shower, and throwing a world-class piss fit before any of that, it stopped raining long enough for me to get the tire on the car. Later on at night, in the pitch black, I was able to get oil in the car and get it started up. It took a little bit, but as soon as I got it going, like an absolute sewing machine. What an absolute trooper. He survived my first timing chain fiasco. So, a little bit after recording that, I was going through the computer, and I saw smoke. And I didn't think anything of it. With it being cold out, and the exhaust and everything, I didn't think anything of it. And I rolled the windows down thinking, you know, just the burning oil. Then I realized that smoke's pluming out the side of the car, but it's not on fire yet. But we have a serious issue. So I'm thinking, if the car does go up, I'd like the windows to be up, because might as well ruin the outside of the car, not the inside. At some point during my haste of getting everything put back together in one day, I had managed to pinch this gasket for the harmonic balancer. Not the harmonic balancer, the crankshaft pulley. Whatever, same thing. So, going to bed because it had been late and everything was closed, I felt defeated. I was out my car once again. But bright and early the next day, I rushed across town to the parts store and grabbed a new gasket. It took me longer to get the new one in than anything. And yes, this was replaced with the timing chain gasket. Timing chain cover gasket? The big one.
That's what she said.
That was replaced at the same time. It's just it been off, on and off, 4 times.
That's what she said. No time! But she did. No time!
Thankfully, that's where the leak was coming from, and as of this recording, we have not had any other oil leaks. So hopefully everything is fixed. As for the big question, does this clear the code? I don't know. But that one hasn't come back. But we have more codes now.